1971年7月9日，时任美国总统国家安全事务助理基辛格秘密访华，促成中美打开了交往的大门。7月9日，纪念基辛格秘密访华50周年活动在北京举行。基辛格通过视频方式致辞，他表示，1971年美中实现关系破冰的重要前提是，美国承认世界上只有一个中国，承认台湾是中国的一部分。现在这一前提依然有效。
The president's visit in February 1972, a series of understandings were reached between the United States and China. The most important was that the United States acknowledged that the Chinese people consider Taiwan a part of China.And that there was only one China, and that we would not challenge that proposition. So here we are, 50 years later, in a situation in which the need for cooperation has not diminished, but.The mechanisms and the procedures and maybe the understandings have not yet been fully worked out. But it remains important for the world and important for our two countries to understand that the premise which led to the visit in 1971 is still valid. In fact, even more valid than it was then.
基辛格表示，时至今日，美中两国间的合作需求并没有减少。他呼吁双方能尽快展开对话，以解决当下的分歧。
And I therefore hope that a serious dialogue starts soon again on the major issues.Between us, each nation should designate an individual with the confidence of their president to guide this discussion, and that we owe it to each other's people and to the world to settle our differences by dialogue.And mutual understanding. And I would like to think that I made a perhaps more limited contribution from my side to this dialogue. So at this moment, peace, stability, and progress in the world.Depends on the wisdom of both sides.
近年来，美国一些政客声称当年秘密访华所开启的对华政策失败，并认为美国应该与中国脱钩。1972年尼克松访华时的翻译，美国前助理国防部长傅立民明确反驳了这种观点。
And in the Shanghai communique, both sides acknowledged that our socio-economic systems and histories were different.And said, nonetheless, we have things we can cooperate about. So let's set those differences aside and get on with cooperation. And it worked. It was very good for the United States and for China. So I completely disagree with the assertion that engagement failed. And I hope we will re-engage in the spirit with which Dr. Kissinger opened this relationship.
基辛格秘密访华时的中方翻译唐文生也表示，中美关系在过去50年中的发展得益于两国领导人的政治洞察力和长远眼光，这对今天的中美关系仍有借鉴意义。
我想就是当时的领导人是有政治洞察力的，看到了问题的本质，而且能够看到视野是非常广阔的，而且呢有长远的眼光。 而且明确的承认双方是有分歧的，双方是不一样的，谁也不是想通过 这种接触啊。但是呢，我们又有共同点，有共同利益，我们可以发展这些共同利益，可以在这些共同点上做很多事情，是对双方有利，对世界也有利的。我觉得这一点是特别重要的，没有这一点就不可能有当时打开中美关系，双方走向正常化。我觉得这一点依然对今天是有借鉴意义的，是值得我们继承和发扬的。
当天的活动由中国人民外交学会和美国美中关系全国委员会合作举办，中美双方300余人通过线下和线上视频连线方式参加了本次活动。